Governor Walker's signature makes it official. Reaction on a balanced budget that some say makes too many deep cuts. The governor's pen officially signs the budget into law. Thanks for joining us. I'm Andy Choi.
And I'm Maria Guerrero. The budget plugs a $3 billion shortfall, but also slashes funding for public education. News 3 political reporter Jessica Arp spent the day in Ashwaubenon, where Governor Walker signed the state budget, Jess.
Well, and the governor made 50 vetoes before signing that state budget, but not making any changes to some of the major cuts he says were necessary in the next 2 years. Cuts his opposition says could be devastating to the state.
The budget finally sat, waiting for the governor's signature after months of protests, discussion, hearings, and closed-door wranglings for its final provisions.
Through honest budgeting, we're providing an alternative to the reckless tricks and gimmicks of the past. To move forward together, we're acknowledging that we have to make sacrifices to protect the next generation.
Governor Walker signing his first budget in front of a Green Bay area crowd. The spending plan makes drastic cuts to public schools in the UW system, but holds down most taxes and eliminates a $3 billion deficit.
It's a rather historic event. It's like most families in the state. Anytime that you can balance your budget and pay your bills and at the same time hold property taxes down, it's a good thing.
Now, the recent debates in Madison found us spending far too much of our time focused on our differences instead of our similarities. Well, today, we're going to turn that page. We're going to move this state forward.
But the protests of the past continue, people lining the street outside of the signing, showing their opposition to the budget.
I think it's immoral, and I think people that aren't in unions need to stand up for all of the stuff that's in the budget that has no place being in there.
They say they'll now focus on recall elections, but Republicans are confident the budget will instead be a boon to their efforts.
The sky's not falling, and Wisconsin's going to be here, and the schools are going to be fine in the fall, and I think people are going to see that, and that's the message we need to get out there.
Republicans have certainly gotten a victory by finalizing the budget just days before the fiscal year ends, but it is the fallout that remains to be seen.
Congratulations.
Now, Walker did make some changes to the budget. He vetoed an allowance for bail bondsmen in the state, vetoed restrictions on viewing politicians' economic interest statements, made a veto allowing the UW chancellor to bypass the Board of Regents with pay plans, another veto that requires state workers to be with the state 5 years before getting pension payouts, and another partial veto that now exempts all EMTs from the collective bargaining law. He did not veto a provision which could limit the abilities of craft brewers in the state, nor a provision related to UW hospital funding related to abortions, which the hospital is concerned could jeopardize their accreditation. The governor did not take questions following the signing from any media on these vetoes today.
Certainly a historic day, whichever side you're on.
That's right.
News 3's political reporter Jessica Arp reporting. Jessica, thank you very much.